Hello, Market Club members everywhere. Adam Hewison here, coming to you from the digital studios of Market Club. It's Friday, the 25th of September. We're coming rapidly to the close of the third quarter. And most of the indices, in fact, all the indices, are lower for the quarter. And that's the important thing to remember. It's the big picture we want to look at. Right now, we're looking at a daily chart of the Dow. And you can see quite clearly that you have broken below the line right here, which is a continuation pattern of the downside. You have a longer term trend line here, not super long, but certainly from the July period right here. And you are just about a little bit unchanged for the day. Last week, we closed at 16,384 with 16,363. So we're still lower for the week, but nonetheless, the reality is the longer-term picture for this market is down. All we have to look at is our monthly, which is right here. And we have a mixed trading range, which you say with a 65 and also with our weekly up. We're waiting for this weekly to turn down. It didn't do it yesterday. It got very, very close. As you can see, we were going for this number here, right here to be, well, it just touched a little bit above that and then rallied, obviously, today with Janet Yellen's statement. By the way, for the record, I think Janet Yellen is totally out of her league and incompetent. It's like the Peter Principle. She's risen to the highest level of her incompetency, and she's dealing with a lot of very strong-minded guys. So it's not a good place for Janet to be in. So we'll see what happens there. But nonetheless, let's look at the markets. This market is about unchanged or a little bit lower for the week. And let's see how it closes. It could well close anywhere. It's just anyone's guess. But we are below the RSI line. Pretty much the same picture with the S&P 500. You can see we've broken the trend line. We've just drawn it in very quickly for you right here. And we really are still below the 50 line. Nothing to get excited about. We closed last week at 1,958. So we're still lower for the week, even with today's pop-up. So I wouldn't be surprised if this rally fails and we start to see a little more downward pressure. But we have had 3 days down the road. It's not unusual to see a counter trend move. But nonetheless, we are in a trading range. Remember that. The major is down, the major trend down, intermediate trend up, indicating a trading range. So this is not so unusual. On the NASDAQ, you can see that we're a little bit lower for the week. We closed last week at 4,823. We're 4,773. So we are lower for the week. We're below the 50 line, really. And it's a trading range. So that's the key thing. It's just a chop, chop, chop. I would not be surprised to see the market close lower than we are currently trading right now. So let's see how that plays out. Now on the euro, it's a mixed picture there. Even though we've got a weekly and a monthly positive, the daily is what we use for timing, and that's down, indicating you should be on the sidelines in this market at the moment. We've just moved below the 50 line. You can see that right here. So you want to be a little bit cautious on this market. You don't want to be long at the moment. Wait for the green triangle to kick in on the daily, then get long. Gold is very interesting. We had a buy signal yesterday. I'll just put that in for you so you can see right there. It came in at 1,140. It's 1,142, so you should still have profits. I think this pullback in gold is an opportunity to be a buyer and not a seller. So I would be buying gold on this pullback. Certainly the 1,140 levels of the original buy. I think if you can get it around these levels, I think you'll be doing pretty well for yourself. I think we touched 1,140.96. So got very close back to our original buy point. I think it's an opportunity. Something is going on and gold is saying it wants to go higher. It is also higher for the week. Crude oil is also higher for the week. Not by much, but certainly it's higher for the week. And it just peaked over the 50 line. Again, it's kind of strange. I don't have a strong feeling now for this market. We thought it was going to go higher, but we've seen some reversals. It may have to go sideways for a little while longer before we get an established trend. Next week, by the end of next week, we'll be trading in the fourth quarter. Should be great opportunities in the fourth quarter. I think a lot of people will be happy to see this market move out of the third quarter and into the fourth quarter. Hey, I'm Adam Hewison. I hope you learned something with this video, and how important the trade triangles are to spotting the trends and telling you when it's a trading range. Have a great weekend, everyone. Thanks for watching. I'll be back on Monday.